Alright, welcome, let's take an extended look at a modern classic, the IBM ThinkPad T60. A look back at what might be the greatest work laptop of all times. It is still in daily activity as an office machine and at home, which speaks for its long-term quality. It was the last machine with the IBM label but has a Lenovo tag as well. Business hearsay was that ThinkPads were too expensive to make and lost money, so IBM sold their brand to Lenovo. Design follows traditional ThinkPad aesthetics, simple, timeless, robust, and square, and everything has a function. T60 comes in a 14 or 15 inch model, biggest differences are of course weight and screen size. The T60P variant with P4 performance has stronger graphics cards and higher resolution displays optional. T60 was updated twice with the T61 and T400, similar machines, still using Core 2 Duos, so not a generational jump. T410 was a true successor going to the new Intel Core architecture. Chassis is old school and very nice, sturdy with a structure frame inside which prevents flexing, a problem that plagued the earlier T40 line. A dock connector allows for a dock, of course, and port replicator that support digital video out, DVI, and old school serial and parallel ports as well. There are also drain holes if you have some water spillage on your keyboard, but I am not testing it. So how do you restore and clean that surface? Well, I made an unconventional video about it, so check it out. Looks great again. T60 introduced some important new features compared to the older T43. We now have new CPUs, maximum R-Core 2 Duo instead of Pentium M single core, and that is a big improvement. We have SATA disk instead of old school PATA, we have 3GB of RAM instead of 2 maximum, we have mobile broadband optional, a Windows key first time, and 16x10 displays optional in the 15 inch model. The T60 was also the last one to have some iconic features, like IPS Flex View displays. It took until the T440p to return. We also lost an infrared port and 4x3 displays, which disappeared completely after the T61. So when people said that Lenovo quality went down, that is part of the answer. Let's take a look at ports. Backside has battery, power and fan exhaust. We got a new bigger 20V power connector compared to the 16V power connector before. Left side has fan exhaust, VGA, modem, Ethernet, microphone, headphone, USB 2, card bus and Express Card 54. The X marks Express Card on top. And is quite useful today, for example, to add USB 3 ports or an SD card support. The right side has disk cover, 2 USB ports stacked, Kensick lock and ultra bass slim with an eject button. It comes with optional DVD, second battery or disk drive. You can also reduce weight by using an empty cover. T60 does not have serial or parallel ports anymore on the chassis, but there is an adapter for the Ultra Bay, which is difficult to buy today. Alternative is a docking station. Front has a Wi-Fi switch, a screen latch and an infrared port, and I made a video about it, so check it out, it is actually quite interesting. Also optional are fingerprint reader and Bluetooth, which we do not have here. Also webcams do not exist at all in this generation. Everything has a light, like a Christmas tree. We still have 8 or 10 lights on the display bezel, 3 more on top, plus 2 Ethernet and 2 Ultra Bay lights. Plus the infrared light and sync light, and you end up with 19 lights in total. Quite beautiful. The upgradability of the old ThinkPads is legendary. This model was built in 2007. It came with a Core Duo, 1 GB of RAM and a small hard disk. CPUs are single or dual core and removable. We have a Core 2 Duo now, 2.3 GHz maxed out. Still good enough for office use. One more tip, use TP Fan Control software to reduce fan noise. It runs nice and silent now. You can replace a small hard disk with a modern SSD, of course, but there is a SATA 1 speed limit. So let's take a look inside. There is no flap on the underside, so you have to remove bezel and keyboard on top, so take a look. It came originally with 1 GB of RAM, upgraded it with dual channel. Max is 4 GB physical, but BIOS limits us to 3 GB usable, which is still good enough for office use. There's a BIOS hack available to remove some of that 3 GB limit, but I wouldn't try it. A mini PCIe slot has a Wi-Fi card in it, but you cannot install an mSATA SSD here. We also have a dedicated connector for a modem card, optional Bluetooth. Some boards have a second mini PCIe slot for a mobile broadband card, but our board is completely empty here. The T60 had 5 graphics cards available as an option. We have a venerable Intel GMA 950, which does not support many modern features, but it runs cool and quiet, so good for office use. The ATIs can pack a punch for gaming, but run much hotter. Okay, so let's play some games. The Intel graphics is quite limited, but it still works for some older games, so here we go. Quite a choice of displays available here, 4x3, 16x10, TN or IPS, it is all here. Compared to a 15-inch IPS model here. TN displays have lower contrast and limited viewing angles, so not really good for media and images. Hinges work like new, the chassis was made to last. Speakers are quite decent actually, loud enough and clear, so let's hear a bit. Best part is the keyboard, still excellent after all these years. We have 7 full lines of keys, long key travel, good haptic feedback and nearly no wear and tear. Nothing better on the market yet. We also have dedicated volume and speaker mute buttons and some flexing in the corners. Of course it has the iconic track point with the accentuated buttons. Trackpad is quite small but works okay. Still an afterthought squeezed below the keyboard. Compare the old layout to a modern ThinkPad here. You can also run Linux from a USB stick. I installed Mint on a USB stick and it worked fine, so take a look. It came originally with Windows XP, upgraded to Windows 7 some years ago, best choice for stable use. Windows 10 works fine except for some of the ATI graphics that have no dedicated drivers. There are some wonky solutions online for that, but Windows 7 works better with the ATI. The main battery is removable plus a smaller optional Ultra Bay battery. Battery life is not great, some hours maybe, and you have to buy aftermarket batteries nowadays. And still, it is the oldest laptop that works every day and one of the most iconic ThinkPads of all time because it does exactly what it was made for, an international business machine. Okay, thanks for watching. You can check out my playlist of ThinkPads as well.